Coming to the next slice, what we see here is these are the three branches which we saw, and we saw that the SVC is getting formed here by the union of two brachiocephalic veins, the trachea and the esophagus, the rib, and this is in the vertebra. You see this spinal cord, that is the scapula, the posterior bone. Coming to the next section, again the trachea, we saw the vessel which was formed here, the SVC on the right side, and this is the aortic arch. Very important, which can be asked in exam. It looks like an arch, so that's the aortic arch. Number 7 is the vertebral body. Number 8 is the rib coming from the vertebra, which is joining there. This is the scapula. Number 5 is the left lung. Number 1 is the right lung. Second is the trachea, which we have already seen. Third is the SVC. And number 4 is aortic arch on the left side. Now, if we go at the section below, we see that you have this aorta, the aorta. So anteriorly, it's the ascending aorta. Posteriorly, just near the vertebra to the left, is the descending aorta. So that's the ascending aorta, descending aorta. If you go to a higher section, you see the aortic arch. We saw that this on the right side is the SVC. Now this is the trachea, which is starting to get bifurcated into the mainstem bronchus, and this is the esophagus. It is black because it is containing air. So esophagus can contain air, and it can look black when it is distended with air. This is the right lung. Number 5 is the rib. Number 6 is the left lung. 7 is the esophagus. Coming to the next section, what we see here is, now this is the pulmonary artery. This is a very important section, very frequently asked. You need to know the arrangement of the vessels in the thorax. From right to left, it is SVC, aorta, and the pulmonary artery. So that's the SVC, aorta, pulmonary artery. Anterior to the pulmonary artery, you see this pulmonary vein, number 6. Number 7 is the left lung. Number 8, we have seen already, is the scapula. Number 4 is aorta. 3 is SVC. And 2 is pulmonary artery, right side. 1 is the right lung. And 10, we saw, is the rib. Coming to the next section, again, very important, 3 SVC, 4 aorta, 5 is the main pulmonary trunk, and you see that it is dividing into two vessels. So when you see any vessel which is dividing in the thorax like this, that is the pulmonary artery, because it will divide into right and left, and it is on the left side. So that's the main pulmonary trunk, the inverted Y shape, the branching of the pulmonary artery. That is what you see there. What we see next is, this is the lung, the ribs, the scapula. Number 6 is the pulmonary vein. Number 7 is the left pulmonary artery. 2nd is the right lung. Coming to the next section again, SVC, aorta, pulmonary trunk, and this is the descending aorta. Very important, anterior to the vertebra on the left side. Next section, what we see here, this is the right atrium. That's the SVC, which is opening in the right atrium. So that is the right atrium, SVC opening here. So again, this is SVC, aorta, pulmonary artery root. This chamber of the heart is the left atrium. How do we identify that? It is in close relation to this esophagus, the posterior most chamber of the heart, that is the left atrium. And what are these vessels which are opening in the left atrium? We know that the pulmonary veins open into the left atrium. So this is the right pulmonary vein opening in the left atrium, the right atrium into which this SVC is opening. So SVC, this is the aorta, this is the pulmonary artery root. When you see here pulmonary artery root, you trace it down, we know that it arises from the right ventricle. So this becomes the right ventricle. If you trace the structure here in the middle structure, that was the aorta. So as you are going down, this is the aortic root. You go down, it's coming from the left ventricle. So that is the aortic root, the right ventricle, the right atrium, left atrium, the pulmonary veins opening into the left atrium. This is the descending aorta. Now this is the left ventricle, very important. It can be identified by, number one, you draw a line on the midline, so it's on the left side, so that's the left chamber. Plus it has a thick muscular wall. This is the muscular wall, which is very thick. So that is the left ventricle. This is the right ventricle, the interventricular septum, the right atrium. This is the descending aorta. So again, this is the left ventricle, the right ventricle, the ribs, right lung, the left lung. And this is the esophagus, just anterior to the descending aorta. That's the esophagus, left ventricle with the thick muscular wall, right ventricle with not so thick wall. It is on the right side. We know that right ventricle is the anterior most chamber, so you will see it just behind the sternum, the bone near the sternum, just adjacent to it would be the right ventricle. So right ventricle, left ventricle, esophagus, descending aorta, left lung, spinal cord, right lung. The structure here which you are seeing, if you trace it down, we go to the next section, you trace it. So this is the liver, and you see the vessel coursing through the liver. This is the IVC. So trace it up, IVC, 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 and it's opening in the right atrium. So it's opening in the right atrium. This is the IVC. Coming to the next section, right ventricle, left ventricle, esophagus, descending aorta. This is the vertebral body, the spinous process. These are the lamina, the right lung and the left lung. This organ on the right side through which the IVC is going is the liver. So that's the liver, the IVC, the descending aorta. Again, the IVC, the descending aorta and the liver. This is the lowermost part of the lungs, the lowermost part of the lungs, the right lung and the left lung.